amazing. I love like the feathers, and it's very kind of typical Galliano makeup. It's lovely. Say you don't know. You say you don't go. I say. I'm always just staring at all the girls because everybody looks so incredible, and I'm just like, you know, always really excited to see what they've come up with. This could die. I want you. I want you.
How's your photography doing?
Yeah, it's going well. I did a show in Berlin in February, and then I did a show in London in April. So which was just really fun, you know, nothing pretentious. We just had tea parties every day, and we found this really lovely old space. It was an old horse hospital where me and a friend from Holland, Victor de Bie, he's a painter. So we did a show together, and now after the shows I'm gonna do a bit of traveling in Asia to work on a project. So magazines and movie screens, still in her mind she's 17. Now her life has turned into make-believe. I want to start off in Hokkaido in Japan, and to photograph the Ainu. They're the first settlers of Japan. So, and then I'm gonna go into Kolkata and travel up to Nepal, and travel back to Mumbai and do some Southeast Asian stuff. So we'll see, it depends on how much time I have. She found out it's not so easy. Alcohol drains her completely. There's just one thing that you never want to miss. I haven't had as much time for it as I want to, but you kind of have to, you know, you have to do this when it's there as well, and do the modeling, and so, you know, I'm just trying to start combining things together. Forget the past, but on the inside she's still torn apart. For me, there's always enough work to go around. Just, you know, it's kind of nice to put your mind into something, and it keeps your spirit up as well. She tries celebrity life, drugs and bottles and supermodels. I bought a little camper van in April, so we drove up to the Czech Republic, and we just drove around the country, and we went to some castles and some medieval festivals, and it's beautiful. I wanted to head more into Eastern Europe as well, but I only got to Czech, and it's a very kind of magical place, I think. It's really lovely.
An ideal vacation for you?
I don't know. I'm quite an explorer. I like visiting new places all the time. But I really, really like going to Norway. So I normally go there every summer. And the north of Norway is beautiful. One of my friends, she has a little house there that her family's built, and it's right in the fjords and the mountains, and it's really beautiful. So yeah, that's where I like to venture to. I think people are not really in touch with nature so much anymore, and for me, being in cities all the time, it's nice to get a break sometimes and just, I don't know, go horse riding or yeah. You up and make you mine. Get to the grinding. Stay now, we got ourselves a long, long time. Give me fever. It's all over and all day long. I don't have any animals, but I love horses. I think they're the most beautiful creatures, and I would love to just live in a little cottage at some point and have some little horses. But you know, at the moment it's kind of tough because I live in London. So.
you were an animal, Yekalin, what would you be?
Well, I'd probably be a horse, I think.
And why is that?
I don't know, they're just... I can't really explain. I just think they're very very magical, I think some horses say. Very smart, and, which I'm not saying that I am. Lasted a lot longer than I thought it would be. I mean, in the beginning when I started modeling, I was like, oh, I'll do it for 1 year to, you know, do something next to school to make money, and then it's kind of taken off and, you know, taken me to where I am now. So that's, you know, you have to just take advantage and just do it, you know, and it could be worse.